the events occur and the body is overwhelmed. And I really want us to take that as seriously as possible, because often, I don't know about you, even with all my years as a therapist and a somatic therapist and a body worker and all the things, I still sometimes forget that it's a physiological reality, right? Because it shows up as thoughts or emotions or whatever, and I'm not always present to the sensations, but that overwhelm is a physiological event. And it's why, you know, as a therapist, it's not uncommon for me to experience with my clients, people saying, well, you know, I know that, and they've got it all figured out, and they're like totally not connected to what their body knows, or they're like, I understand it, why can't I change it, or whatever it is, and it's because people are so not present to the physiology of things.
I resemble that remark.
So when the body's overwhelmed, the autonomic nervous system comes in to protect it, and I'll talk a little bit about that. But the autonomic nervous system is, you know, it will give you the fight flight response through the sympathetic nervous system, the freeze immobility through the what's called the dorsal vagal system, and it often comes in the form of anxiety, frustration, fear, anger, agitation, hopelessness, numbness, depression, and dissociation. Right? So it's an odd system, but it seems to be what our biology and our physiology have given us. And there's utility in this when you're dealing with an event and an overwhelmed body. Because usually you can do something, like play dead until the bad thing goes away, or run away, or scare it off, or whatever you can do. Usually that actually helps you do something that is survival based. And that gives rise to the behaviors that emerge out of it. As humans, another thing happens, which is we create meaning. And we make meaning about the event, about the experience of the body, about our response to it, and we can create all kinds of stories about that. Sometimes very proactive, I'm a hero stories, sometimes it's a horrible experience and I'll never be able to cope with it stories. Something's wrong with me stories are very, very common. Something's wrong with me, especially, I want to say again, in our culture, which everybody is basically supposed to be happy and functional no matter what. You're having a hard time, that's your fucking problem.
Right.
Not the culture's problem, not the environment's problem, not anything else. So that on, you know, and I have to say my industry has not improved this very much at all. I actually feel pretty bad about it. And the years it has taken me to have the both and approach of, yes, there's individual pathology and individual experience that, you know, lends to the experience. But I would say increasingly, and this really connects with the stuff you were talking about food and, you know, food is medicine. Increasingly, our bodies are coping and our systems are coping with things that have nothing to do with us at all. It's all the environmental impact. Mm-hmm. I also want to give acknowledgement. I acknowledged earlier.